Naturally, like every other American parent, I am troubled indeed by the revelations about Mark Foley sending sexually explicit emails to teenage congressional pages. But I'm stunned about the amount of attention the subject is getting in the national media.
As Mark Foley rides out the storm in rehab,
it's 24/7 on all the cable news networks, all over major front pages.
Tonight, the Foley Factor.
And leading the network news. I agree, it's a big story, but let's put it in perspective. There's a war on in the Democratic Republic of the Congo in Central Africa. Something roughly like 1,200 civilians each day are being raped and or murdered or dying of disease or hunger in that war. Millions have died, and rarely does anyone in the major media mention it. In Darfur, Sudan, there's an ongoing genocide taking thousands of lives every day. Rare media coverage. The security situation in Afghanistan, which we thought we had conquered a few years ago, is collapsing. Half of the country is Taliban infested. Our commanders there are begging, yes, begging, for more troops, planes, and helicopters, and their pleas are going unanswered. The Taliban, which sheltered Osama bin Laden, is resurgent all over Afghanistan. If we lose there, and we are losing, Osama bin Laden has beaten us again. And if Afghanistan falls to the Taliban, Pakistan will likely fall to the Islamic fanatics in that country. That would be a catastrophe, since Pakistan has a large arsenal of nuclear weapons. But nowhere is this gathering disaster mentioned except on egghead shows for people like me. You can call me crazy, but while emails about gay sex to a minor are important if they come from a congressman, aren't 1,200 lives a day in Africa important? They're just as important as your life and mine are. Isn't the likely victory of a terrorist movement in Afghanistan and the possible emergence of a fanatic-led nuclear Pakistan important? The Foley story is a big story, but in the interest of pursuing a sex scandal, we're ignoring matters of life and death for the whole planet. Countries that don't know what is life-threatening and what is not do not last. I'm sorry to say, that's us right now.